Hello, I'm Lee Hae-sung from Korea's Focus.
And hi, I'm Chambo.
Chambo, which movie genre do you like the most?
I am a huge fan of science fiction, my favorite movie might be Interstellar. It's so emotional, but it's got the perfect blend of what is now and what might be in the future. And I dreamt of going into space, but one cool thing that's happening these days is that consumers can now just go to space just by paying money. So Virgin Galactic recently launched 3 civilians into space.
So shall we talk about space today? So could you briefly introduce yourself?
Hello, my name is Jung Young-jin, a professor at the Graduate School of Korean National Defense University. I've been teaching space law and space development history and space defense policy at the National Defense University.
Wow. Oh, hello, I am Min Seo-hong and I'm an intern at the International Technology Rules and Cooperation Division at the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
So at the International Technology and Rules Cooperation Division, that sounds like you do a lot of diplomacy mixed with science and technology. Could you tell us a bit more about what you do there?
It's a new department established early this year, and its tasks and responsibilities include the establishing the diplomatic policies and concluding bilateral or multilateral international agreements about advanced and emerging science and technology, and also negotiating the formation of the international norms about the science and technology.
So recently, space technology seems to be a trend in the science and technology field.
There are no international agreed upon standards on where airspace and the space begins. The American physicist von Karman suggested that the boundary between airspace and space is about 100 kilometers above sea level, because at about 100 kilometers, the air suddenly gets thinner and you feel no gravity. That's why we call it space travel when we go up to about 100 kilometers. Mm-hmm. Of course, it's still expensive, but the space travel era has already begun.
So how far has Korea's space development and technology come?
Space launch vehicle Nuri was made purely by our Korean's own technology. So Korea became the 7th country in the world which have the space launch vehicle technology. Mm. Yes.
Yeah, congratulations to Korea. So what is space launch vehicles exactly?
Space launch vehicle is a rocket system that can place artificial objects such as satellite into a desired orbit in outer space. We need a powerful propulsion force to escape the Earth's gravity. The engine then create this force is the key to the space launch vehicle. The launch of the Nuri rocket, I think it clearly demonstrates the country status in terms of diplomacy and security.
Yeah, so that's a really big step in terms of Korea's space development and in the technology field. Yeah, I'm kind of curious to learn about how space development has worked in other countries on a more global level as well.
As countries around the world have enhanced their space technologies, the technologies of the private sector have advanced as well. The Nuri rocket has around 370,000 components, and about 300 domestic companies participated in its production and assembly, of which about 90% are small and medium-sized enterprises. So we can say that the Nuri rocket has discovered the small and medium-sized enterprises and also improved their technological capabilities. Private companies have significantly expanded their R&D budget on their own in the space sector, and their innovative ideas have led to new forms of space activities such as space tourism, low-orbit satellite internet, and low-cost small launch vehicles. So governments are actively supporting these kind of activities.
So in the past, actually, the space was considered as a one area of the exploration, but recently many people are pay attention to the economic opportunities that mm-hmm. space of war. So with this trend, there is several types of industry in space development, such as manufacturing, satellite and space launch vehicle. And also there is communication equipment industry and space tourism. And there is space debris collections industry, like we can see in the movie named the Space Sweeper.
So I'm reading a biography on Elon Musk, and according to that book, reusing space launch vehicles seems to be a hot issue over the past years. Is that true?
Yeah. While conventional rockets were disposable with the presentation of a reusable rocket, the price of launching a launch vehicle has decreased, and the demand for launching satellites has skyrocketed, showing the rapid growth of the space industry. Mm-hmm.
So several countries and companies are jumping into the space development industry. So it seems like cooperation between countries will be more important than ever in this new space age.
Yes, according to the Outer Space Treaty signed by the United Nations in 1967, every country is internationally responsible for the space activities of private companies. That's why private companies must receive a license from the government to launch space launch vehicles and operate satellite. And currently, there are more than 90 countries with at least one satellite. Since more than 1.1 million satellites are expected to be launched in 2028 alone, there is a growing consensus in the international community to create a space environment where satellites can continue to be operated safely. And so cooperation between countries is essential for this.
Wow, there will be a traffic jam out there.
It's going to be like Seoul traffic pretty soon. I feel like with that many things around the Earth, there's a lot of chance for some sort of accident to occur.
The exponential growth of space junk could collide with the functioning satellite, causing massive damage. Also, satellite might collide with each other as the space environment becomes overcrowded. In 2009, a Russian satellite and a US communication satellite crashed at about 790 kilometers in orbit. We estimate the number of pieces of space junk that are larger than 1 centimeter and smaller than 10 centimeters to be about a million, but we cannot track them.
Recently, the Korean Ministry of Foreign Affairs and the U.S. Department of State jointly held the ROK-US Space Forum to celebrate the 70th anniversary of the Korea-US Alliance. So could you tell us what was on the agenda?
At the summit in last April, our President Yoon and the President Biden mentioned that the alliance would be effective in space and promised to strengthen the space cooperation. So in this response, Korea and U.S. government prepared for this forum.
You know, like Minsa said, this ROK-US Space Forum took a huge importance. It is not just a simple forum to exchange science and technology, but was a meaningful forum since it had seven sessions regarding various agendas, including space diplomacy, security, exploration, and economy, and discussed various ways of cooperation through the special sessions, such as gender diversity and space startup pitching. The forum discussed the sustainability of outer space activities.
So which session was the most memorable for you?
As South Korea signed the Artemis Accord, which governs the Artemis program in May 2021, the session on space exploration cooperation was impressive. In this session, both countries outlined their space exploration plans. I think it was a precious opportunity to explore Korea's future role in the Artemis program.
Yes, for me personally, the session of the cooperation on space security was the most impressive for me. And actually, these days when we watch the news, we can easily hear the news of war. And those news remind me of Korea and make me somehow worried about our national security. Mm-hmm. So I thought this session was meaningful considering the context that the range of the world has recently extended to the outer space.
That's terrifying a little bit, like a space war in the future.
I've seen a few movies on that. Let's hope it stays in science fiction and not turn to reality.
What was the title of the movie?
Star Wars.
Very classic. So could you briefly explain about the space and women, space startup pitching sessions?
Yes, the session of space and women was held with Dr. Jung Ah Hwang from Korean Astronomy and Space Science Institute and the US former astronaut Marshall Evans. And they discussed about the difficulties of women who are working in the STEM area, including space. So for me, when Marshall was sharing her experience of space flight, she advised us do what makes you happy. So her word was very touching because it made me think my dream and my future job in a positive way.
So yeah, there seems to be a glass ceiling for women in this area. So I hope that more women work actively in the space field.
And the next session, the startup pitching session, was the program that Korean space startup pitched to the Korean and American investors. So in this session, I realized that there are so many incredible space startup companies in our country. Mm-hmm. So I was really proud of them, and I thought that the future of Korea's space industry is so bright.
So both of you seems to have a very busy November. So were there any difficulties or memorable episodes while preparing for this forum?
I had the opportunity to reflect on the role of the Korea-US alliance in the space sector and the role of Korea in the international community.
While preparing for this forum, I learned that the Ministry of Foreign Affairs continuously works to increase Korea's security and development efforts in cooperation with various partner countries and related divisions. I'd like to quote one saying that Carl Sagan, the author of Cosmos, said, the Earth is a very small stage in a vast cosmic arena. So I believe that this universe is a vast space, and this is a space that humanity should be headed to.
Today we started with space travel, and then we talked about the latest space development trend and the importance of space security. So it would be nice to discuss the norms of the peaceful use of space next time. So I look forward to seeing great advances and cooperations in the new space age. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Bye.